Hey there. I am John Michael Vestal, and I will be playing Henry Higgins in our show of My Fair Lady. And Parker has asked me to do some videos today, so that's what I'll be doing. Yeah, that's it. Aye.
All I want is a room somewhere, far away from the cold night air, with one enormous chair. Oh, wouldn't it be lovely?
Hey, can I buy your daughter?
Yeah, hold up. This time, I think I'm gonna need about, 10 pounds, I'd say. Just a good run for myself and the boys. So 10 pounds will do, I think I'd say.
Deal. Ethan McDonald, our student musical director, and so Ethan.
Oh! Sorry, Alfie in his prime.
That's like a blooper.
Okay, well, Ethan, what is your favorite part of the show musically?
So my favorite part of the show musically is when the Cockney Quartet and Wouldn't It Be Loverly first comes in all together, because the barbershop quartet harmonies kind of create something called an overtone, which makes it sound like there's a fifth singer when there's only four singers, and it's just super cool, and it sounds very good and rich.
Heck yeah, music!
Music. So, here's my musical tip for all the viewers, like Mr. Cal Ritchie over here. So, if you want to sing in a good acoustic, but don't have any good music halls, go in a stairwell, because usually they're super echoey. And singing in stairwells, even though you'll look crazy, is a good way to have a good acoustic.
Music tip of the day. This is Cal Ritchie. He is Jamie, one of Alfred P. Doolittle's little people, I guess? Groupie. Yeah, you're his groupie. And so I wanted to ask you, what is your favorite, because in Little Bit of Luck, you guys clown around a lot. So what's your favorite thing to do? What's your favorite action, I guess?
Well, there's one part where Alfie, he taps our shoulders, and we look around, and we run into each other on the beat, and we fall down on the ground. And I also like at the part, at the end, he bangs our heads together like the Three Stooges. It's really cool.
Cool, thanks. About to hear some beautiful people warming up.
You just figured that out?
I look so rough. It's hot. Warm. Great, they're gonna load. They're not gonna load the water. Oh, here they are! Okay, so our first question we got was from Emily. And it's, what do you think is the most important thing you have learned from playing your character? I think it's that you can be messy and raw and authentic and real and still a lovely human and still a good heart, have a good soul.
That's great.
Yeah.
You got an advantage. You get to read the question. What did you say?
Oh my god.
When you let your guard down, wonderful things can happen.
Put it in your own words.
Quote.
Okay. What are your characters' middle names? You have to go first.
Kennedy told me it was something. It was something with an H.
It was something incredibly effeminate.
Yeah, it was like Heather or something.
Don't think that's right. Don't tell them that.
No, that's not right. But like that's what my mom told me. So, I guess
so what do you think his middle name is?
I don't know. Something pretentious.
Like, yeah.
Like Albert or something.
I'm gonna walk in and call you Albert now. Oh my god, alright, you can't change it.
Okay,
I don't think Eliza has a middle name.
Wow, that was really good.
I got you. She doesn't even have a mother. Why would she have a middle name?
I'm pretty sure she has a mother.
No, she's born of start.
She was actually She was a factory. They had made a new factory.
She's an AI.
Yeah. Oh, look, Xfinity Wi-Fi.
Oh, cool. Okay. This is from our lovely director. We have a few from her, actually.
Oh, God.
How does it feel to play two of the most iconic roles in musicals?
I don't know. It's kind of intimidating. Because, you know, I'm scared people want, like, a cookie cutter. Cookie cutter Higgins, you know?
But you are not.
Yeah.
Which is good.
That's what I've heard. Yeah. But, I don't know, it's intimidating. It's kind of thrilling, because, like, I don't know, so many people have portrayed this role before.
Yeah.
And, you know, I'm one of those people now, so
that's good. For me, it's really, like you said, it's kind of thrilling. It's kind of intimidating, yeah. Because, oh my god, I have the same answer. People expect to see, I don't know, I think a lot of people who, like, grew up with the film expect to see, or don't expect to see, but, like, have this picture in their heads of, like, Audrey Hepburn and Rex Harrison, and we are not them. And
I'm not Rex Harrison.
Really?
Yeah.
So, anywho, yeah, no, I think people expect to see or Julie Andrews or Audrey, and I just, but it's also kind of exciting, I think, because I love our Higgins and Eliza, and I love how we have made them different and like made their relationship a little different, like still keeping true to the story, but I think we have a really fresh take on the roles, and I think it's a lot of fun to be able to explore that. Also, Julie Andrews is my mom and I want to make her proud. That's all.
Rex Harrison is not my dad.
Do you think he'll watch this? Do you think he'll get offended?
Rex Harrison? Rex Harrison, if you're watching this, you're not my dad.
You are not the father. It's too early for this. Oh, goodness gracious.
Are you crying?
A little bit.
Don't cry, you silly girl.
It's still draining. It's early. Oh, also, I want to make Lisa O'Hare proud. I love her. Okay, I'm sorry. Okay. Oh, and Kelly O'Hare. Oh my god, there's so many women who play this role. Okay. What have you learned about theater through this production? You don't have to be cookie cutter. Like, just because something has been done a million ways the same way before doesn't mean you have to do it. Also, I've always known this, but this show has really, really emphasized that it takes a village. We're sitting looking at this gorgeous set right now, and none of it would have been possible without literally like 100 people in a million different directions at all times trying to get together this like beautiful sofa, this beautiful Victorian sofa we have, or like this 15-foot set, which is just crazy. Like, oh my god. Yeah, it takes a village, and it's very humbling because as the actor, I know I am just part of the finished product. I only know My Fair Lady.
I don't know, this is one of the first, well, I mean, obviously not the first, but one of the first roles that I've really gone into the subtext of more than others. Like in our Before Without You.
Oh my god.
Fight.
Yeah.
There's...
It's all...
You can just ignore the actual words that we're saying.
Don't look at what we're saying.
Because it's all subtext.
That's not what we mean.
Nothing what we say is what we mean.
Nope. Which is impressive. Like, come on, Liza.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah, you learned a lot from me, didn't you? Don't you hit me!
Hit you, infamous creature! Alright, what are you most excited for to people... Okay, we have to hurry up. What are you most excited for people to see in this show?
You want me to go?
Yeah.
Honestly...
Spilled on myself. I'm sorry, continue.
Do you want to be late?
You literally just answered the question.
probably David Murphy and David Forsman.
Oh my god, David Forsman.
They're both so great.
Yeah, David Murphy too.
I love them so much. I love watching them because they're just great. I love working with Fors. Because
awesome.
He's easy to work off of.
He is. He's so fun.
Like an ordinary man.
Oh, God.
It's just so easy for
me. I'm excited for you guys to see them just, like, play.
It's so easy for me to do ordinary man because he's so easy to play off of. It's just fun. Awesome. We're just having fun.
What am I excited for? I'm excited for people to see the set.
Oh, yeah.
Like, the actual set. Like, when it's done.
Yeah.
I'm excited for people to see the ending.
Embassy too.
Oh, Embassy.
It's beautiful.
Embassy's gorgeous.
It's so pretty.
And he's so easy to dance with. It's
wow,
so fun.
Thanks.
He's a lot of fun. So, yeah, I'm excited for Embassy. I'm excited to be with him.
I do.
Oh, I got stuck in your glasses.
It's okay.
It's okay. All right. Who is Eliza's mother? I think that's a question for me.
No, it's a question for me.
Okay. Who is Eliza's mother? I don't know if Eliza knows who Eliza's mother is. I think a lot of women have been rotating in and out of her life. And I think that's why her relationship with Mrs. Higgins is so wonderful. Because it's kind of the first female figure in her life, to really care for her. And, give her advice. Okay. And be on her side. And I think that's lovely. Oh god. And I love our Miss Higgins Kennedy.
Yes.
Is
that's my mom.
Wonderful. Like she is just she's like I love her so much. Okay, so yeah. I don't think Eliza knows. I mean I'm sure it's someone.
Yeah, it's gotta be a person. It's gotta be a person.
I don't know who though, okay. Are Higgins and Pickering a thing or not?
Listen here. That's a great, insightful question, David Connell. Here's a great answer. No.
How old are each of your characters?
Mid-30s.
Mid-30s?
Yeah.
I think they say about 21. I think she's like between. No, I need an age. I have to have an age, or it's gonna drive me crazy. I'll say 20.
20.
She's 20. She's young.
Yeah, obviously.
She's young, and I think. But I think that's like kind of the fun part about Eliza, because she's like kind of an adult, but she's like kind of not.
She's an adult, but has no idea how to adult.
Yeah. Does Higgins have any idea how to adult?
No, I didn't say he did.
Okay. Just making sure. Okay. And last question.
He knows how to make money, though.
That's good for you. That really brought you a lot of happiness, didn't it?
Yeah.
How does it feel that this is your last Shuler show, Parker?
Well, I think,
It makes me a little sad. I've had an awesome journey with all the shows here. I'm really excited that this is my last one. It's such a special show. It's taught me a lot. It's taught me a lot about myself. It's made me grow as an actress, certainly. It's like the best show vocally for me I've ever done. And I get to work with this one a lot, and I love him. And so, yeah, it's a gift. I'm really, really happy. I love Eliza. I love her journey. I love her story. And I'm really excited to share it with you all. We're excited for you to see it, I think. Are you excited?
Yeah, I'm excited.
All right, thanks guys. Bye.